In this video, we're going to talk about industry-specific applications of wastewater management technology. Mark, g'day, how are you?
Good, thanks, Tim.
So I know that you guys work across a variety of industries, you know, half a dozen or a dozen in all, but let's talk about some specifics and try and get some applications or recommendations for each one. Let's start off with the mining wastewater control and management sort of sector. What sort of things come up again and again?
So that's quite a large application. So you can imagine the mining vehicles are quite huge. So
yeah, sure.
Their wash bays are just tremendous, and the volumes of water are equally the same. So in the mining environment, we're dealing with quite a lot of water that we have to process, prepare, and typically prepare that for discharge to environment, like, for instance, local streams and creeks, etc.
Okay, so that's the specifics for the mining industry. Let's talk about a different industry, such as the car wash industry. Now, I guess the wash bays must get a little smaller, but also maybe there's local sewerage and so forth?
Absolutely. So we're, of course, talking about a much smaller wash bay. It's a lot more repetitive. So we focus on water recycling in that market. Having access to the sewer network, the water quality is not as stringent as compared to the mining. So there's less we need to do to the water prior to discharge.
Okay, good. Let's talk about another industry here. And this one might actually make a distinction between the more permanent wash bay installations and some of the more portable ones, the transport industry. What advice could you give or observations might you make about the transport wastewater management and control?
Great. Transport has quite a wide range, from trucks to containers. So we then start to touch into, if we're looking at sea freight, for instance, a quarantine aspect. So we're starting to clean containers that have been overseas, and we have to make sure that we treat the water to a quarantine level and discharge accordingly. So as far as the wash bay, you also have the ability that if you're dealing with trucks, you may not look at a permanent wash bay, you may start to look at a portable wash bay, depending on that the client may decide to pick up and leave their location as the business grows, so they can take that portable wash bay with them.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. And finally, let me ask you about, this is a bit generic, I guess, but industry uses, possibly food industry as an example. What are some of the distinctions when it comes to industry wastewater solutions and management?
So we seem to touch on roughly around about 14 different industries. A lot of them are made up of wash bays of some nature. So whether it be a wash bay for a small part or a large vehicle, helicopter, whatever it may be, to then the food industry, preparing the water, again, for discharge to sewer, and it's important that we meet certain criteria stipulated by water authorities and local council.
It's not often that you think of cleaning a helicopter, but there is one main rule. Do you know the rule for cleaning a helicopter?
No.
Never while the blade is spinning.
Yeah, it's true.
That's the main rule. All right, terrific. Any other industries you'd like to talk about or make specific comments about?
Another industry which has become quite popular is the car hire industry.
Oh, yeah.
And equipment hire, like Kennards, Hertz, etc., that are hiring out equipment when the components or vehicles have to come back, they're cleaned, and we've got solutions, whether they be permanent or portable, for those.
All right, terrific. Thank you so much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. Send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to chat about the specifics of your situation and how to help you in particular.